We were on the southern portion of the Nickle Plate Trail. We, I went down to the inn there that's behind me, 96th Street. It doesn't quite get to 96th Street, so I'm gonna have to find my way to get down to the track that I was gonna follow on home. I mean, I guess I could take everything back, but. Yeah, we'll see. I forgot to set the tripometer, so been trying to do throttle as much as possible because my legs can't really stand up to that much pedaling. So. But we'll see if we can get home this way. Nature preserve here. Go check that out. Unfortunate, because I would like to have seen this. Yes. The bad thing is areas like this, I've seen a lot of posts on Nextdoor, the Nextdoor app. People's cars get broken in. That's why there's a bunch of signs that say lock it, hide it, keep it. Of course, you can see why. It's kind of out in the middle of nowhere, and everything's by itself, so. Continues across 106th, but I don't know. We'll see where this goes. Really like to follow 96 on the way back because I know there's sidewalks all the way. Oh. nice thing about that Juliet by Eahora, the range is ridiculous on it, so I don't really worry about these long trips. Like I said, we're currently at 23, 24 miles. I've been using throttle a whole lot. That I'm not sure about. We are right next to 106th Street, so we go down Allisonville, we'll get back on 96th Street. Okay. I'm flying through these intersections without looking, but I'm looking in my rear view on the left to make sure there's nothing coming. We've got their turn signal on, and then I'm obviously looking to the right where these apartment complexes and such are. Thank you. it's a green light through here, so, and not any traffic. In this graveyard here, my grandparents are interred. Not exactly sure of the word. They're in a mausoleum. Through the parking lot. Or behind the building. Puts us on 96th Street. This is Hazel Dell, which is where we want to be. So we can run Hazel Dell, we'll run it all the way to the Midland Trace, and then we'll be almost home. crossed for the trail. That's kind of, or no, we don't. Okay. So I have to say, I appreciate everybody watching. I didn't expect even a couple 20 or whatever watching all the time, but I guess I've had about 1,400 unique viewers actually watch videos. I definitely thank everybody that keeps coming back. I know I've enjoyed watching motorcycle trip videos in the past, and I enjoy watching other people's rides on the e-bikes too, because then I get to see other places around the country. Yet to see a bunch around the world yet, but we'll see. So I believe we're kind of going diagonal northeast, but if we went directly north, it would be about 96 to about a sort of like 172nd, which is what, 6 or 9 seconds. I'm trying to do the math in my head. 36. So 7.6 miles or thereabouts. But like I said, we're going diagonal, so it'll be a bit more than that. There's a bunch of construction equipment still there. Too bad of a ride. I'm getting tired, but mainly in my wrist and my legs, but my rear end. So pretty much everywhere you can be tired on a bicycle. But it's kind of surprising how far you can get around. Especially the more and more the batteries will be able to handle more range and have more power. Doesn't have very many people. We've got our first jogger up here. I'm sure the further north we get, there's a lot more subdivisions. Thank you. It's 4:20 p.m. We're getting in the middle of rush hour. It's going to be a little difficult to get across these roundabouts. Fan of brick. Never liked it since I rollerbladed a road bicycle. You ladies on the right. Hi.